Three drinks, Christine. That's all it takes to be legally drunk.
He left a boy in the road to die.
We could get this guy behind bars in a couple of hours.
It isn't even our case.
Want to know what wears me out? The thought of some man staggering back to his car with a boy laying in the street.
How much you drink is none of my business.
See, there you go again.
Here's to the ladies who can hold their booze, whatever it is.
Do you think I have a problem with booze?
You're overreacting.
I am very much aware of what I drink and how much I drink. So the problem of my drinking is yours, not mine.
Michael, I'm not accusing anybody here, but we got missing cheese. Embezzled mozzarella. Purchased Saturday at Battaglia's Deli. Suddenly vanished under mysterious circumstances. Do you have any idea who the perpetrator might be?
No.
Michael, how do you think we ought to proceed on a case like this?
Well, I can go get some more.
That's a good idea. Come on. Okay. It's 4:29, precisely. You go straight there, come straight back. Here is $5. I want the change. And you've got exactly 7 minutes from go. Ready? Five. Four, three, two, one, go! Michael! And speak slowly. When you give the address, make sure they get it right. Okay, go, go. Anton?
All right. Everything is gonna be all right.
Boy,
everybody wanna step back about 10 steps. Mr. Shevsky,
A lot of times these things look worse than they are, all right? So just talk to him. Make sure he doesn't move, all right? Make sure he doesn't move. Ambulance is coming. Okay.
Listen up, everybody. Listen, I'm going to need to take his statements. Anybody who witnessed this, all right? Let's just back up here, shall we? Anybody got a
Right.
What's your name?
Dorothy. Mary Beth, what were you doing questioning witnesses? The doctor said you deliver early. You're supposed to stay in your apartment with your feet up. Harvey must have had a fit.
Harvey and the doctor did not see what I saw, Christine.
Well, how's the kid?
I don't know yet. Harvey took Mrs. Dashevsky to the hospital. They said they'd call when they know something.
Then we probably shouldn't tie up the phone. It would be wrong.
Listen, I'm so glad you were home. It was good to talk to somebody.
Yeah, well, take it easy, okay?
Yeah. And good luck with taking over night shift, Sergeant.
Hey, piece of cake, Mary Beth. Running graveyard for 2 weeks? Be like a vacation.
Oh, I gotta go. There's somebody knocking at my door.
Uh-huh, mine too. You're so rude.
That's very rude. I find it up on the phone.
It's a little hard to ascertain the degree of inebriation from a sixth-floor window. Now, wouldn't you agree, Mrs. Lacey?
Detective Lacey, 14th Squad. I'm on leave, but I have an ID. And no, I could not testify in a court of law that the perpetrator was drunk, but he certainly appeared to be. He's a male Caucasian, reddish hair, 45 to 50 years old, between 5'10 and 6 feet tall, approximately 160, 175 pounds. He's got a beige three-quarter trench coat over a gray suit. You got that? The vehicle said Todson Properties on the side. I have statements from several witnesses. With a little hard work, we could get this guy behind bars in a couple of hours, am I right?
We already have him, Detective. The driver dropped a dime on himself. He called us from a payphone.
Mary Beth?
Excuse me. Mrs. Dashevsky, how is Anton?
The doctors, they could not tell me. They say my Anton is still with...
In a coma. They don't know when he'll come out of it.
He'll be okay, Mrs. Dashevsky.
Mrs. Dashevsky is going to get a couple of things, then I'm going to take you back to Queens General.
Okay.
Excuse me. There's a hearing at 10 in the morning, Mrs. Dashevsky. You should be there if you can.
They got the man who hit your son. The hearing is for him.
I'm sorry, I don't understand. What is a hearing?
Don't worry. I'll go with you. I'll explain everything.
All I'm trying to say is that a guy who's had one too many is not a criminal in the same sense as, say, an armed robber. Or a rapist.
Hey, if you haul me off in a body bag, it doesn't matter if the weapon is a 38 Smith & Wesson or an 86 sedan. It is still murder.
From the police viewpoint.
From anybody's viewpoint.
The guy was probably too bombed to know what he was doing.
He left a boy in the road to die.
The point is, he did not intentionally set out to hurt anyone.
Oh, I see. You have a couple of shooters before you hit the road, huh? And to hell with individual responsibility. I mean, if anything happens, it's just the other guy's tough luck, huh? Excuse me, please. I beg your pardon?
Drinking and driving is irresponsible and stupid and dangerous. And I bet about 90% of the social drinkers in this country have done it, including you.
When I drive, I always stop at 2. Maybe 3. But when I get behind the wheel, I make certain that I drive with extreme caution.
You do, huh?
Yes, I do.
That's what they all say.
I told you, they call me the monk.
The monk, that's right. And Detective Muzaski.
The mongoose.
The monk and the mongoose, of course. How are we tonight?
Okie dokie.
Yes, I was going to tell you, your checks are right here. Actually, I'm glad that you gentlemen came in, because I wanted to say I know how difficult it is when there's somebody new, well, in charge.
Difficult for you already, Sergeant?
No, I meant, well, for you, Monk. You've been in charge of this ship for, what, a year now?
18 months.
Right. Well, being second whip, I will be doing the graveyard shift for 2 weeks, familiarizing myself with the routine. And detectives is Becky and Petrie, also from Days, will be doing their rotation, and I see no reason why we can't, well, all coexist in peace and harmony.
None that I can think of.
Excellent.
Have a nut.
Well, thank you. Oh, golly, I love practical jokes. Uh-huh. So let's try and make this experience as pleasant as possible, shall we? You continue with your routine, and I will certainly do nothing to interfere.
We have no routine to interfere with.
Well, whatever it is you do, just continue to do it. Okie dokie.
Okie.
Okay. 8 million stories in the Naked City, and there go two of them.
I feel like I've already earned my next week's paycheck.
Patience, gentlemen. It's something we could all use more of. Marcus, you shaved your mustache.
Yeah, I got tired of what it looked like.
Hope that never happens to me.
I like it. Looks good.
I never figured you were this kind of hobby, Keg.
It's not a hobby. It's a present for my father. He made one for me on my 10th birthday. Worked on it for months, every spare minute he had, and he named her the Christine.
So what happened to her?
I lost her when we moved. I started this one in the hospital when I got shot.
Keg, my paycheck is missing.
It is there. It's there, as Becky. Keep looking.
No, it's not. It's gone.
Can't be. I am in charge, Mary Beth. I am responsible for 3 paychecks and an arrest report, all of which are now missing.
Would you relax? They'll turn up. Why don't you go home and get some sleep?
Because I'm wired. I had too much coffee.
Is that why I have the pleasure of your company?
No, I thought that a drive to Queens might relax me.
You mean put you to sleep?
I think it's a lousy idea that you're going to this hearing, Mary Beth.
Oh, don't start with me, Christine. Sonia Dyshevsky needs me, and I'm going to go.
What about your baby?
I am not endangering this baby. Excuse me. Yeah. Hi. Mrs. Dyshevsky, this is my partner, Christine Cagney. I'm almost ready to go.
How do you do?
Mrs. Lacey, I don't know what to do.
Why, what's wrong? Is it Anton?
No, still no changes since I left the hospital. But the office of the district attorney, they say to me that this hearing, it has been canceled. They say the man who hurt my boy has made a bargain.
Plea bargain.
Yeah, a plea bargain. It's when the criminal makes a deal to be punished for a lesser crime than he actually committed.
To bargain for justice?
Well, sometimes it's the only way that you can be sure that someone is punished.
Yeah, only this time it's wrong. So I'm going to do something about it.
You can stop it.
Well, I can
excuse
do the best
me,
I can.
Mrs. Dyshevsky, could you excuse me just one moment? I'd like to speak with Mary Beth. What do you think you're doing?
What's it look like I'm doing? I'm going down to Queens DA and give somebody help.
Remember the doctor? Remember Harvey? Why don't you just turn it over to the 116?
Because the 116
anyway.
Already rolled it over.
So you're getting upset.
I'm not getting upset. You're
upset,
and Harvey's upset. The doctor is upset, but I am not upset. The DA has no right knocking down the charges against some crud like this.
And you're not supposed to be going out.
I'm not
going to
let it happen, Christine.
Thanks, Sergeant.
Not at all, Mr.
Carter. My daughter played a mean trick on this guy. Dug him out of the California desert where he was happy and sends him to me in Queens, where he's miserable. She's going to USC law school. Wants to be a defense attorney. I don't know, you try to raise them right and somehow it turns out all wrong.
Uh-huh. Look, Mrs. Carver, Carl Todson has had 7 priors over 10 years. Eyewitnesses saw him drunk at the scene, and now you want to knock a driving while intoxicated down to a misdemeanor? Why?
The case is wobbly. Your witnesses lack credibility. In the first place, they were too far away. Secondly, they're not experts. His lawyer would slice them and dice them.
One of my eyewitnesses, an off-duty cop who happens to be my partner, saw him leave the scene.
His attorney said he went to search for a police car.
Oh, bull.
Wait. Gets better. In shock, he was unable to find the elusive police car, so he stopped at a payphone and promptly called the Queens PD.
Exactly. 3 miles from the accident in a bar. He failed the breathalyzer cold.
According to his attorney, Todson knocked back several martinis after calling the police to steady his nerves. He claims he failed the breathalyzer for alcohol consumed after the accident.
Mrs. Carver, if he can't sell this story to you and me, how's he going to sell it to a jury?
Ha! There isn't one of them who hasn't left a Christmas party on rubbery legs. Look, in 6 months I retire. Before that, over 1,000 DWIs will roll through this office. I'd like to prosecute as many winners as I can. The rest are a waste of time and energy. That's my story, Sergeant. Now, what's yours? Why are you so interested in this case?
So, then what happened? So then, I brought up an independent reckless act. Perfect. Smart, Christine. You were really on your toes. Yeah, I thought so. Anyway, she went for it. You find the witness who can testify that Todson was too drunk to drive before the accident, Carver will slam dunk him. She also will delay disposition of the case for 3 days. 3 days? So the 116th better get on the stick. It's not a lot of time to find that witness. Night, Mary Beth.
Hey.
Hi, honey. I left you a note. The leftover cannellonis warming up in the oven. Harvey Jr.'s on the telephone, and Michael's got his nose stuck in a comic book. Would you remind them that they said they do the dishes?
Slow down, Mary Beth. What's going on?
I'm gonna go see a boss.
No, Mary Beth, you are not.
Harvey, Christine got us 3 days from the DA's office. Now, it's not a lot of time to build the case, but the 116 said that the drunken driver called from a Callahan's bar.
Somebody else can build the case, Mary Beth. You're building a baby.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We're so lucky. We're so lucky, honey. We got the baby, and we got the boys. We got each other. Mrs. Dashevsky's only got her son, and she doesn't know tonight whether or not her son is going to live or die. And the 116 says they're too short-handed to get somebody else, so...
Call this bartender, Mary Beth. Ask him these questions over the phone.
Oh, that's not the same thing, Harvey. I gotta look in their faces.
You want to have this baby early? The doctor said it could happen.
Well, what do you want me to do, sit home?
Hey, look, Mary Beth, it is my baby, too, and you are gonna wear yourself out.
You want to know what wears me out? The thought of some man staggering back to his car with a boy laying in the street. Could have been Michael.
Yeah, I know.
There's a whole lot of things could happen to a kid in this city, Harvey. Most of which I can't do anything about. But I could get a drunken driver off the street. At least I could try.
It's hard, isn't it, being home all day?
Oh, honey, it's your slow season. That slow season. Your slow season's gonna be over in a couple weeks. I bet you have about 1 million jobs. I mean, I could feel it getting warmer every day.
Liar.
Look, I got an address here for a Callahan's bar. You wanna help me find it?
I got a better idea. Yeah, my old man. Used to take me to the fights all the time. Saw you against Giardello. Old Hammer and Hank. Let me ask you a question. Who was the toughest guy you ever fought?
That Giardello was tough. Hey, they're all tough. You know, I'm loving this little stroll down memory lane. But you didn't come here to talk boxing. Now, did you? Officer?
No, you got me all wrong. Harvey Lacey, that's me. See? I'm a contract. I'm not a cop. But you're half right. I didn't come here to talk boxing. Yesterday,
A drunk driver hit my neighbor's kid. He's still in a coma. He's my son's age. The driver called the cops from here. Do you remember the guy?
I remember him. Came in to put in a call to his lawyer.
Was he drunk when he arrived? It's real important.
Maybe drunk. Maybe in shock. Couldn't get enough coffee down. And his lawyer calls him back. The guy starts socking away vodka martinis.
And then he called the cops.
Even had a few more waiting for the cops. I should have served the guy a bottle and a straw. Drank like he had something to prove.
This one's gonna widen the inspector's paw. Oops, sorry.
Got a message for you, Kegan.
I don't want to hear it. I want slumber. I just want to go home.
You want this message or what?
My brain and I are off duty.
Lacey called. Said she needs you. Sounded like an emergency.
What do you mean it sounded like? Was it or wasn't it?
Sounded important. I didn't rate it.
Oh, damn it. You keep trying Lacey and tell her I'm on my way?
Cagney, what the hell is this?
It's an arrow, Lieutenant. Is it time? What? Coleman said it was an emergency. I thought it was the baby. I didn't say emergency. I said very important. Oh, I thought it was the baby. All right, I'm here. So what's so important?
Well, Mrs. Dashevsky called this morning, and she said Anton came out of the coma.
Oh, that's terrific, huh?
Yeah, but they think he might have brain damage. And he's got to have special bone surgery on his left leg. Doctor said it costs a hell of a lot of money.
Well, at least there's no fault insurance in case Tarzan tries to weasel out of it.
No, no, Christine. She doesn't have no fault insurance. No fault insurance only goes up to $50,000. Now, with the operations that Anton's got to have and therapy, they said it could cost up to $100,000.
So she can sue for pain and suffering. God knows she's got a case.
Well, it's not foolproof, Christine. Not until we get Todson. If he's in jail, they can make him pay still in a civil suit. I checked.
What is this? Huh? You invited me over here just so I could do something for you.
It's not a lot, Chris. I would do it myself, but Harv said it might snow, and he made me swear to stay in. It's one little thing.
I'm tired. I haven't had any sleep at all.
We only have 2 days left, Chris.
It isn't even our case. Forget it.
This will take you all of 45 minutes. No more. Listen, Todson said in his statement that he had lunch at a place called the Marquis. Go to the Marquis, talk to the bartender, see if he remembers Todson.
Was that all? Well, you're sure while I'm there, you don't want me to interview all the regular clients.
Gee, that'd be great.
You're obsessed, Mary Beth.
I am not obsessed.
You're obsessed.
I'm not the one that gets obsessed. You're the one that gets obsessed. Hey, if it's an imposition, forget I asked.
Don't do that. Huh? If I don't go to the Marquis, you'll go, right?
I didn't say that.
Of course not. That would be way too obvious. I just visited the Marquis. Your boss had lunch there with a Mr. Provasali prior to the accident.
He's from Boston. He's interested in some income property. I made the reservations. Look, Mr. Todson did not intentionally hurt that boy. He is not a criminal.
He's sick. This is his 7th drunk driving charge in 10 years. I think your boss has a drinking problem and needs some help.
You know, maybe this is hard for you to understand, but he happens to be a wonderful man.
After Mr. Provasali left, Mr. Todson went into the bar, and he had a drink with an attractive redhead. I can't make out my own handwriting. What's her name?
I wouldn't know. Listen, I have a lot of work to do, and I don't want to answer any more questions.
Well, they left in his car around 1:30. The accident occurred around 4:30. Where do you think he was for 3 hours?
I have no idea. I want you to leave now.
Look, I understand you're being afraid of losing your job, but you don't ever have to tell your boss that you talked to me.
I am not going to help you put Carl Todson in jail.
Even if that's where he belongs.
Carl's my husband. We have 3 kids.
Is this Chris Cagney I'm talking to? Chris Cagney, who pushed me into worse long shots who knows how many times when it was something she wanted.
Well, thank you, Mary Beth. You know, it's so nice to do somebody a favor and then have them take pot shots at your character.
You're right, I'm sorry.
No, you're not. You're mad. Because I think it's hopeless.
I'm mad because you want to give up and forget about it like everybody else. Nobody can make the problem go away, so nobody should try.
That is not what I said.
DA wants to sweep it under the carpet. The 116 is only looking for a quick conviction. So what if Carl Todson sometimes has a few too many and then gets in his car? We've all been there ourselves, so what?
I want to wait a minute, Mary.
We've all seen cops go out and get smashed right after they arrested a drunk driver. And we all know cops and lawyers and judges who drive drunk, so big deal. Too bad about that kid being in the hospital, though, right?
Mary Beth, you're not being very rational about this, so I'm going to go home, okay?
Sure, you don't want to look at it either. 3 drinks, Christine. That's nothing for you. But that's all it takes to be legally drunk.
What is that supposed to mean?
I got kids. I got a different point of view on drinking.
Oh, I see. You don't drink, and I do. So that makes me one of those cops you were talking about?
I didn't mean you personally.
The hell you didn't.
You're overreacting.
And you talk before you think. Let me tell you something. Drinking does not a drunkard make. I am very much aware of what I drink and how much I drink. I am not irresponsible, I do not drive drunk, and I do not think that drunk drivers should get off lightly. So the problem of my drinking is yours, Mary Beth, not mine.
Nothing for me. Chris?
Sure. I'll have another Bloody Mary's glass.
First time I ever saw you drink anything but scotch.
The hours I'm keeping, this is breakfast.
Here's to the ladies who can hold their booze, whatever it is. He's not Liberace. But at least he's having a great time.
Well, hey, if you can't have a good time, what's the point?
These hours are catching up with you.
Hell no! I love burning the candle at both ends, working for my partner all day long in the city of New York all night. It makes me feel needed, you know?
Relax. Just let it go for a while.
Must be my lucky day. Women who hold their liquor are still in demand.
That was a compliment, Chris. You trying to pick a fight?
Guess so. Sorry.
Hey, if it helps, I'll go a few rounds.
Do you think I have a problem with booze?
No. You like to drink. So do I.
Yeah, I do. So do a lot of people. Charlie really used to have a good time. I remember when I was a little girl, he used to let me sit on his lap and have some of his beer. Chrissy, he'd say, if you can't hold your liquor, you're not old enough to drink. Which is sort of funny. Thing to say to a kid. I'm sure Charlie would tie one on every once in a while, but I never really thought about it at the time. I never noticed the progression. And then one night, a few months after he retired, I get this call from Flannery's, and they tell me to come down and get him. That was the first time I had to put Charlie to bed. First of many.
I know the doctor's right. Charlie knows it, too. He's an alcoholic. It's a disease, you know. The doctor said if he didn't lay off the booze, one of two things could happen. You either go insane or you die. They say it can run in the family.
Where did all this come from?
Think a candelabra would help?
You know, you don't have to do this, honey.
It's not a major drug bust, Mary Beth. I'm just gonna find out the redhead's name.
Maybe I'm pushing too hard.
Huh?
Maybe I'm pushing both you and Chris too hard.
Not me, babe. I wanna do it.
She was so mad, Harvey.
Chris will get over it.
I mean, I didn't mean to upset her. But I don't want to give up on this while there's still a chance.
I'm with you 100%. How do I look?
Is that that shirt your cousin Stanley gave you that you promised you'd never wear?
It's perfect for the marquee. I hear it's a hot pickup joint.
You need some gold chains, huh?
Love that silk. Live alone?
I'm just waiting for someone.
Aren't we all? You want to talk to me?
Oh, no, no, miss. Look, I don't mean to be rude, but the only reason I'm here is because of my wife.
Yeah? That's kinky.
No, no, it's not. I just want to talk to the day bartender. They told me to wait here.
Okay. You're looking at the day bartender. What can I do for you?
You. Tomorrow we get a name. The bartender promised.
But she only knows this redhead by sight, right?
Yeah. She's going to wait till she comes in and find out her name. Simple, huh?
Yeah, if the bartender's playing straight, wouldn't you?
Gave it 20 bucks to make sure.
20? Oh, I don't know if that was such a hot idea, Harv.
I thought cops do it all the time.
Only in the movies. I mean, I could see $5, maybe. After she came through with the name.
Yeah, well, it's worth 20 bucks if we get that witness. Sleep tight, baby.
Yeah, you too.
Tomorrow's a big day.
Uh-huh.
We get that witness and pow, we nail Totson.
Uh-huh.
Boy, this police work, it's hard to turn off.
It's hard, Harv, but do it.
Hello.
Good morning. I wanted to catch you before you went to bed. I hope you weren't asleep.
No, I wasn't, Mary Beth. That's sweet of you to ask.
Listen, Chris, about yesterday, I'm sorry if you misunderstood what I said.
Was that supposed to be an apology?
Christine.
You forget it, okay, Mary Beth? It's over. All right?
If you say so. I called to tell you that Harvey got a couple leads.
Wonderful. Congratulate him for me.
The first is the bartender at the Marquee. She may be able to identify the redhead, but in case she doesn't pan out, Harvey called one of his welders.
Ramon.
Ramon tells Harvey that the reason the Marquee got to be such a popular place is because the adult hideaway motel is right down the street.
Very convenient for some people.
Let me guess. You want me to go check him out?
Well, Harvey wanted to, but he had to take Michael to the dentist.
You wouldn't have to go until you wake up.
I'll try, okay, Mary Beth? But in order to wake up, I have to go to sleep first. Good night, Mary Beth.
Thanks, Chris. Good night.
hideaway motel.
Jehovah's Witnesses.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. You caught me at a bad time. I'm on my way to the adult hideaway motel. Excuse me.
Yeah. Mr. Smith, the last of the big tippers. He sends me to the liquor store for a fifth. Tells me I can finish what he and the lady don't. And what they don't finish could fit in a thimble.
The lady, tell me about her.
A red-headed stallion.
A what?
I used to work burlesque. All the girls were classified with physique. Huh. The tall ones were stallions and the short ones were ponies. She wasn't no pony.
did he call the stallion by name?
She wore a necklace with gold letters. R-I-T-A.
Rita.
Chris. Hey.
Harvey.
How you doing?
I thought you were at the dentist.
Hey, great kid, Mikey. No cavities. I wanted to get here as soon as I could. The bartender promised me the name of Totson's lady friend. But the bartender's a no-show.
Oh.
What brings you here?
Bellboy at the hideaway motel said that the woman's name is Rita, and that he brought her and Todson a fifth, which they polished off.
Rita?
Yeah, I don't know anything.
You want to talk to me?
Yeah, hi. I was here before. I'm trying to find out about a woman who was here on the 17th. Her name is Rita. I could look at your credit card receipts. Maybe I could find her last name. She may have picked up the tab.
I can't do that.
You were very helpful when I was in here the other day.
Yeah, well, I spoke to my lawyer, and he reminded me about the general obligation law. Customer drinks in here and go down to somebody. I get sued?
I don't know. This has nothing to do with the GOL. I'm trying to find out how much he had to drink after he left here. And I need your cooperation.
Get a subpoena, lady, and you get my cooperation.
What if we get beverage control down here, too, huh? Have him take a long, hard look at your liquor license.
Oh, Harvey, I'll handle this.
Don't threaten me, officer. I run a clean business.
What's that supposed to mean? You wash your hands when you come out of the bathroom?
Listen,
Harvey.
Don't come in here and tell me what to do.
Oh, you listen, pal. See that Lolita down there at the end of the bar? The one wobbling on her high heels, talking to Daddy Warbucks there? How old do you figure she is? Maybe 16? 15?
I'm very sorry. He sometimes gets carried away. I'm sure there's no reason why we can't discuss this calmly.
I got it. Good cop, bad cop, routine. You don't have to lean on me. I'll give you whatever you want.
Boy, no wonder why you and Mary Beth love this. I mean, it makes you feel like $1 million.
Yeah, sometimes.
So now we talk to Rita Quintero, huh?
Harvey, I really think maybe I should go alone. I just think the woman will probably be very nervous.
Yeah, and you don't want a rookie to blow it, right?
No. Well, hey, for a rookie, you're okay.
I didn't have anything to do with the accident. I got out of the car 3 blocks from the motel.
Why?
Why do you think? He was smashed.
So you were afraid to stay in the car?
I was terrified. I hadn't realized how drunk he was. Every time I think about what happened, I just thank God I got out.
That's all I want you to tell the DA.
You don't understand. That afternoon was a big mistake. My husband doesn't know anything about it. I intend to keep it that way.
We need you to get this man off the streets, Miss.
Come on, Katie, let's go home.
We can subpoena you, Mrs. Quintero. You want that?
If you do, I'll deny everything. I'll say that I never saw Carl before in my life.
We have eyewitnesses who saw you with him.
If you can get them to testify, I'll say they're mistaken. It'll be their word against mine.
Please, Mrs. Quintero. Your testimony is crucial. Without it, we don't have a case.
And you have no case.
I was on my way to work. Thought I'd stop by.
Uh-huh. You always go from Soho to the precinct by way of Queens?
Okay. I had the sudden flash that maybe you're out of chocolate chip.
Oh, Lord. Chocolate chip.
Yeah.
Thanks. Ooh.
Where are Harvey and the boys?
They went out to bring me ice cream. Can't believe it.
Mary Beth, I tried with Rita Quintero.
I know.
Well, I'm sorry it didn't work out.
You did your best. I appreciate it. Chris, about yesterday, I hated...
Hey, maybe I overreacted. But sometimes, you know, you say things without really saying.
Well, sometimes you hear things that aren't there. No, I don't want to fight about it, Chris. You're a grown woman, and how much you drink is none of my business.
Now, damn it, see, there you go again.
Can we have a truce now?
No. This is personal with me, and we'll leave it at that. Maybe you didn't mean it, but you were out of line.
I apologize.
I accept. Now we have a truce.
I got him! Come on, could you give me a hand here, please?
Give me a
hand. Okay. Ship.
Tweezers.
Easy, you're too cerebral. Let me do it. I'm an animal.
Highly technical work, guys.
Don't fake it. Come on, really pull here, will you?
Thank you.
Finally. After 2 years before the mass, gentlemen, I give you the Charlie. Oh, it's pretty, huh? I had Lopez, the pawnbroker, engrave a brass plate. Will you see it? It's great. It's great.
Yoo-hoo! Victor, Marcus, you think you could come over here a moment, please?
Take a look behind the file cabinet.
Our missing paychecks?
A rat's nest.
What is it? Where?
Oh, at the door.
Banzai!
Oh, you missed it! You missed it! It's over there!
Get out of the way, Bob! Get out of the way!
No! No!
I think you just stunned him.
Cuff him! Around the neck!
2 years! All that work, all that time, all that patience.
Don't take it so hard, Sarge. Come with me. Come on.
You dirty rat.
I don't understand.
I used one of mine. See, I've been on midnights 5 years now. I can knock these suckers off with my eyes closed. You wouldn't guess we'd have a lot in common.
If you didn't work nights, we could have lunch.
Mrs. Quintero?
Yes?
I'm Detective Lacey, 14th Squad. My partner, Sergeant Cagney, talked to you yesterday.
I already told her I can't help you.
I only need a few minutes of your time. Is it asking too much? We're talking about a child's life here.
Kitty, honey, take this into the apartment. How often do I have to tell you, Detective, I can't help you? I'm sorry.
Tell Anton Deshevsky how sorry you are. He may have brain damage. And they don't know if he's ever going to walk right again. Tell his mother how sorry you are. She's looking at her son, and she's looking at doctor bills the rest of her life. And the next time that Carl Totson gets in his car plastered and maybe kills a kid, you can tell those parents how sorry you are, too. But don't apologize to me.
You make it sound like I'm the one who's guilty.
There's 10,000 children a year in this country murdered by drunken drivers. You think it's not your problem? It could have been my kid. It could have been yours. What if it was? What if it was Katie? How would you feel if you knew that somebody could have kept her from getting hurt and did nothing? Oh, lady, if I had another choice, I wouldn't do this to you.
But I don't know another way to make sure this man doesn't hurt more children. Now, you could take a small risk and maybe do a lot of good. Or else you can go ahead and go inside your apartment, close the door, and let a criminal like Totson keep getting away with it. That's up to you.